गुड मॉर्निंग लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन. आई थिंक लिटिल डिफरेंटली एंड somebody come over here to help me locate my. This is the one property. Where is my presentation? Okay. I think I clicked the right one only. Thank you. This should be the. You showed me that it was cancel it. Who uploaded it? Please call somebody. They uploaded my presentation. I am not able to locate. Please, where it is? The first one. Please try to see the first one. The first one, yes. No. This is not the only one. You might be opening a wrong folder actually. Yes, open it. See, you have run away from the place. Okay, thank you. So the theme I have chosen for this presentation is, we are going to share with you some of the strategies that we have thought of, and the opinions and views expressed herein are not necessarily shared by the company where I work. IOCL has been in the business of creating inventions and their commercialization right from the beginning of its setting up R&D center to attain self-reliance in the area of lubricants in the year 1972. Trend of filing Indian patents in the area of domestic appliances and lubricants commenced somewhere in the mid-1970s. Lubricants and kerosene stoves developed by IOCL under the Servo and Nutan brand names entered the Indian market. And for our domestic appliances, we won the WIPO gold medal way back in early late 70s. With the globalization of Indian economy and R&D center entering its second phase by initiating activities in the areas of refining processes and synthetic chemistry, increased patent filings in India, USA and other foreign countries were witnessed in the mid 90s. With a focus on commercialization during its third phase, massive efforts were in place on internally commercializing the refinery processes developed at R&D Center. We have certain concerns, and concerns are our annual filing of inventions during past 15 years have remained more or less stagnant. Further, the actual financial returns on account of our internally commercializing the inventions have not been accounted for. Inventors' involvement in preparation of applications and response to office actions leaves very little time for R&D, and their involvement in preparation of application response to office action, it's risky and is akin to self-medication. Okay, if I have a fever, I know that I have to take the Prucin or Dispril, that is something like that. After all, inventors are not experts in IP issues. Certain other areas of concern, many of our inventors are engaged in routine non-research activities. This must be happening with other organizations also, such as field trials, refinery visits, material procurements, and other activities, etc. Visits by our inventors means mostly comprised of R&D scientists and engineers, to refineries who have taken license for their process units from reputed international licensors may also make IOCL as an infringer of their confidential information. Another area is samples received from different vendors are tested, where IOCL may become a third party infringer. IOCL has therefore decided to reorient its focus on the commercialization and enforcement of its inventions for their licensing and strengthening its IP portfolio by increasing the pace of its patent filing. Many of our high-value patents forming the base of our critical technologies are likely to expire in the next 5 to 6 years. This is also another major area of concern. Our internal commercialization activities, I have a question which many of my colleagues are not able to reply satisfactorily. Are we sure that we don't infringe any live Indian patent? There are certain gaps in understanding which I have tried to list out. Our practice of keeping every lubricant formulation as a trade secret has drastically retarded our pace of patent filing, which has been reflected in our inability to check large-scale copying of our formulations in the Indian market. Further, our perception of carrying out the commercialization by ourselves has reduced the licensing opportunities drastically, with the result we have failed to convert competitors into collaborators as well as check the invalidations of our patents. Now, according to a WIPO report, which I have a habit of reading at least whenever it comes, I try to read, 85% to 90% of filing in India is by MNCs, non-Indian entities. Indian entities constitute only 15% to 20% of India filing. And the figure that you see, 85% to 90% of filing by MNCs, this is at least 10 times lower than the corresponding figure in China, where the filing by non-Chinese entities in China is about 10% to 15%. With the result, any company trying to enter in China, they have to necessarily take the license from the Chinese companies. The scenario is just the reverse. This scenario is likely to retard the pace of our technology growth in future if corrective steps are not taken now. Further, many IP firms have been set up to ensure that the technologies owned by their masters or clients are not infringed. Patent is valuable, we all know it, when the products and processes are commercialized. The profits from the sale of such products processes bring in the recurring revenue and enhance the brand value and strength of the patent portfolio of the organization. Now, technology is not a technical issue. My technical people might say what exactly I am trying to convey. A technology essentially comprises of three types of IP-related components: patents, trademarks, and lot of undocumented trade secrets. which fly from if one employee leaves one organization, goes to another organization, such kind of trade secrets fly from one organization to the other organization. However, despite their